It is state championship Saturday at Fisher Field in Newton. I'm Jeremy McGuire along with Larry Jantz. Division One, the Madison Bulldogs defending state champ against the South Gray Rebels. Tell you what, Larry, this should be one heck of a football game. An experienced squad against the squad that's feeling the state football championship for the first time.
Each team's going to have about six seniors start out of the eight on the team. And Coach Fred McLean at Madison Bulldogs, you know, they were here first time last year and they won the state. Now they're back to repeat. And they're loaded. They've just landslided most of the teams getting up here to this day. And so South Gray, first time ever for the parents for them. So it's going to be interesting to see how the South Gray Rebels can match up and sustain it. They're going to run the ball about 94% of the time, at least up to this point. And with the wind being a big factor today, I suspect that's what they hope to do is control the line of scrimmage and keep the ball on the ground and keep the chains moving.
How much do nerves come into play today? These teams have played in big games throughout the year, but state championship Saturday, how much do nerves come into play?
Well, I think the nerves always is a factor, but after the first series or two each way, I think they'll calm down and they'll say, hey, it's a football game, it's blocking, it's tackling, gets back to the fundamentals, and whoever controls the line of scrimmage, you know, the hog's in the trough, basically, is going to probably come out the victor.
Both these teams, like you said, like to run the football. If they have to throw it with this wind, that could really be tough.
Yeah, I think it's supposed to be, what, 30, 35 mile an hour today, gusting maybe up to 50, might reach 70 degrees for a while today, then taper off it as they go on. So it's going to be, it'll be an interesting deal to see how the ball flutters in the air and how they adjust it. That's going to be interesting to see.
It should be a fun one. James and John back in the studio.
With Kansas Pregame Magazine and KPreps.com's John Betts, I'm James Westlane, talking eight-man Division I championship football matchup featuring Madison with a 12-0 record under head coach Fred McLean and South Gray with an unblemished 11-0 mark under head coach Jeff Blattner. Madison on the season, their road to the championship, they defeated Mankato Rock Hills in round one, 46-8. They then beat Central Burden soundly 50-18. And John, most recently in the semifinals, hammered Lakeside Downs. Final score in that game, 52-6. My question to you, was that Madison's most impressive performance of the season?
Well, I think it really was. You look at Lakeside's game with Lebo in the playoffs, and Lakeside really handled a Lebo team that played a very good game with Madison earlier in the season. It was a 50-44 win for Madison over Lebo in overtime. And many of the Lebo fans that I spoke with that saw the Lakeside-Lebo game really felt like Lakeside was going to give Madison everything that they could in that semifinal contest. But it just turned out that Madison, they had that big game experience, the defending eight-man state champions. Of course, we're going to talk about all the big names, but certainly Cole Shankey in the backfield, and they just ran away with that game. And a game that we expected to be one of the best games, Lakeside had an excellent season. They had Miles Thomas in the backfield. They had 35 players out for eight-man football. They had several seniors on that team, and they just weren't able to hang with the Madison Bulldogs.
And the Bulldogs are a very deep team this season. Let's talk about their quarterback position. Their starter, Colin Kyle, goes down in that game against Lakeside Downs. Their backup, Tyler Williams, comes in and throws for four touchdowns in the 52-6 win.
Well, Colin Kyle is an experienced player, they need him in those big game situations. But Coach Fred McLean has built a program there, and he has a lot of players that can step in into those positions, in those situations. But that's impressive to step in at the quarterback spot there and get it done when you lose your starter.
And Williams actually threw for three scores. He caught a receiving touchdown for the four total. And then Cole Shankey, you mentioned him, had a buck 49 on the ground, 29 yards passing, and two touchdowns in the Madison win.
Well, Cole Shankey, one of the Kansas pregame eight wonders of Kansas football on the cover of the magazine this season, had an excellent game, I think over 250 yards rushing last year in the state title game. And he does it in so many different ways. He's had 24 career turnovers. He's had 115 career touchdowns and over 5,000 career rushing yards. And, you know, he's listed at 6'1", 190 pounds, but I've seen him in person, and I'm not sure that he's that big. I think he plays beyond his size, his stature. He's one of the best players in all of eight-man football.
And then South Gray, Madison's opponent for this championship matchup, 11-0 on the season under head coach Jeff Blantner. They beat Pretty Prairie in the first round, take care of business against Central Plains, and then had a close game in their semifinal matchup, a 42-38 win over Osborne, in which really their defense was the difference.
Well, I had an opportunity to see Osborne play Lakeside in the first game of the season, and I was so impressed with Damon Scherer, the running back for Osborne. One of the fastest players that I saw play in all classifications, one of the fastest running backs that I've ever seen play football in the state of Kansas before. And so for South Gray to slow that offense down only a little bit, they still got 38 points, but they made a big play when they needed to, and they got a huge win for their program, and now they're playing for a state title.
And they held Osborne to 179 yards passing, 111 on the ground, 290 of total offense. That's a pretty good Osborne offense that they held to those numbers.
And that 111 on the ground is what's most impressive. Certainly Osborne has Ethan Slothauer that was a three-year starter, a quarterback for them. But I cannot say enough about the type of running back that Damon Scherer is. And South Gray, they're experienced, and they played big in a big game, and now they've got a chance to go out on top.
And then quickly, how about Coulter Croft's interception at the goal line on fourth down to seal the win over Osborne?
Well, Coulter Croft on defense and on offense, one of the most important players for South Gray. We're also going to talk about Wyatt Slavin, who's a nice player for them.
He's Kansas Pregame's John Betts. I'm James Westling. Let's head back to the stadium with Jeremy and Larry.
Coach of the Madison Bulldogs, Fred McLean, and Coach, congratulations on your second consecutive trip to Newton.
Well, it's been a nice ride with these kids. They're a new group of kids. You know, we lost six seniors last year and had to replace them, and the kids stepped up, and we're back here, and we're pretty happy.
Minus the Lebo game, you guys have really dominated throughout the year. What do you attribute that domination to all season long?
Well, I'm real proud of our defense. I think when you dominate, you play good defense. You know, you get the turnovers and you get the stops, and you give the ball back to your offense. That's where it all starts. You know, we believe that championships are won with defense, and we take a lot of pride in our defense.
You mentioned the turnovers. You guys are plus 27 in turnovers this year. That is a fantastic number, and that, you know, sets up your offense in pretty good situations too.
Yeah, we call the ball our baby brother. So when we have it on offense, we want to take care of our baby brother and protect him. And on defense, we want to get our baby brother back. He belongs with us, and we're going to tear it out, rip it out. And if we can't tear it out, rip it off, we're going to make you punt.
And talk about your opponent today, South Gray Rebels.
I tell you what, outstanding hustle. They play great team football, offensively and defensively. They're without a doubt the best opponent we've faced this year.
Coach, good luck today in the state championship game.
Well, thank you very much.
That's Madison head coach Fred McLean. When we come back, we'll hear from South Gray head coach Jeff Blattner on Smoky Hills Public Television.
Presentation of the 8-man Division I football championship is brought to you in part by...
From Rural Telephone and Nextech, providing the region with telephone, internet, cable television, and wireless phone solutions, Rural Telephone and Nextech proudly support public broadcasting and all ventures dedicated to improving Kansas communities.
American Lodge and Suites in Heston, offering a welcoming lobby with fireplace, 42 rooms including jacuzzi suites, indoor pool and spa, continental breakfast, and meeting room. American Lodge and Suites in Heston. Welcome to the end of the day.
Max Jantz Excavating, LLC of Montezuma, a contractor specializing in turnkey construction. From feed yard operations to ethanol plants, dairies, and wind farms, your project will be completed on time and within budget. Family-owned Madison Telephone, LLC, serving the Madison and Lamont areas for 65 years, supporting the Madison Bulldogs in athletics and academic endeavors. Montezuma State Bank, a proud sponsor of today's coverage of South Gray, and congratulations to the team on a great season. ADM of Montezuma and Copeland, thanking you for all your business and proud of the jobs our kids have done. Previs Eatery of Madison, offering daily specials, fresh baked breads and desserts, deli sandwiches, and fried chicken dinners, and Sunday lunch. Dina Smith Accounting of Madison, for all your tax and accounting needs. Congratulating the Madison Bulldogs for making it to state. Borth Agency Incorporated of Montezuma, for your insurance needs. Not just your agent, your advocate. Information available at 800-501-7637. Shanky Well Service Incorporated, Madison. Citizen State Bank, Madison and Hamilton. Tricky Insurance of Copeland. Circle K Transport Incorporated of Copeland.
Jeremy Maguire, joined by the head coach of the South Gray Rebels, Jeff Blattner. Coach, congratulations. It's been a long time coming for you and your school to be in a state championship football game.
Oh, yeah. It's a great opportunity for our community, for these kids, for myself personally, and my assistant coach, Grant Salmons. It's just a great opportunity for us, and we hope we can take advantage of it.
What got you guys to this point this year? You guys have played some tough teams throughout the year, a tough sub-state game against Osborne. How have you guys managed to overcome those obstacles and end up here in Newton?
Well, you know, it comes down, you have to have some great athletes, but, you know, everyone has great athletes when you get into the playoffs. I really believe a turning point for us, we as the season progressed, became more and more like a family and a team, and the kids care about each other more than they care about themselves, and I think that helps out a bunch.
How fun has it been to coach this group of kids and see them come together as a team? Like you said, they're not a bunch of individuals, they're a team.
Oh, it's been a blast. The Lord blesses you in so many ways, and the Lord brought me with these young men, and I'm just so fortunate. I really am. I'm just such a lucky person.
When you look across the line today and you see that Madison Bulldog football team, what do you see in them, and how are you guys going to come out with a victory today?
Well, you know, Madison, you know, they're the returning state champions. Coach McLean is a fantastic coach. He does a great job in his staff. But, you know, we're preparing for them just like we did to Osborne. Osborne was a great team. Central Plains was. Pretty Prairie was. You know, our preparation hasn't changed a bit. We know what we're against. But the nice thing about playing teams like this, our kids don't know them at all. So, it's, as far as they're concerned, it's just another game.
Sounds great, Coach. Good luck today, and congratulations on making it to the state title game.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
You're very welcome. It's going to be a heck of a ball game, gentlemen. Back to the studio with James and John.
With John Betts of Kansas Pregame Magazine and kpreps.com, James Westling here with you. John, let's talk matchups. Madison and South Gray. Madison 12-0, South Gray 11-0. This is the 8-man Division I championship. Madison offense versus the South Gray defense. Who do you like in that battle?
Well, you know, we've already talked about Cole Shankey, and certainly he's a fantastic player. And if Colin Kyle is available, certainly he's a great quarterback for them. But I think the real key is that Madison up front is sizable. Bubba Smith is 6'2", 215. Nick Young is 6'2", 280 at offensive guard. And also their experience. They had 8 different players that started that are back this year. Some of those were just one-way players, started on either offense or defense. But with all that experience, with the talent in the backfield and the size up front, you have to think that they have an advantage going into the game.
South Gray's offense, they scored 60 points in their round one win over Pretty Prairie, 52 in a round two win over Central Plains, and 42 over Osborne, a solid defense in the semifinal game. When South Gray has the ball against Madison's defense, who wins that matchup?
Well, I think that, you know, I got to give the edge to Madison's defense because of that experience, because of all, you know, those players that come back, the senior leadership and those kind of things. But certainly you can't discount that Coulter Croft and Wyatt Slavin are both over 1,000 yards. Croft is over 2,000 yards rushing. They both have over more than 30 touchdowns scored this season, so they're explosive players. And they might be battle tested. They've had some tough competition, a couple of solid regular season matchups where they gave up quite a few points, but they were able to outscore their opponent and get the win. But I think that Madison's experience on both sides of the ball is just what makes them look to be a favorite on paper.
Madison and South Gray, both teams unbeaten for the 8-man Division I championship. So in your eyes, is that the biggest difference between these two teams is the experience, or are there a couple other keys to victory for either of these teams that could be the difference?
Well, the experience is certainly a factor just because Madison has more of it. But South Gray, an experienced team of their own, returning 4 senior starters. And, you know, at the 8-man level, your numbers are thin a lot of times on the sidelines. So to have players that are back and experienced is essential and valuable, but I think that Madison has more experience, and that's the most significant factor.
There's a ton of playmakers for both teams on both sides of the ball, in today's matchup, how do you slow some of those guys down? Can you slow down a Colin Kyle if he plays today? Can you slow down a Cole Shankey or a Colton Croft?
Well, you can't slow down Cole Shankey. Only an injury, dare we talk about it, would slow down Cole Shankey. You know, he's a 1,900-yard rusher. Last year, he has 255 yards rushing in the state championship game. And probably the same thing goes with the Colter Croft that's over 2,000 yards on the season. So I think that we have the potential for a shootout, one that could be a high-scoring affair. And you'll run into that a lot, Nate, man. The loss of that force player in the defensive secondary makes it a wide-open track, and guys get going. It's hard to get them slowed down, but it'll be interesting to see how it turns out.
In the postseason, Madison has rolled their opponents 46-8 over Rock Hills, 50-18 over Central Burden, most recently 52-6 over Lakeside Downs. South Gray had a close game against Osborne, 42-38. You mentioned a moment ago about the fact that they're a little bit battle-tested. Does that help them today?
Well, I typically would say yes, but when you mention the scores over those teams that you mentioned,
right.
Mankato Rock Hills was huge up front. I mean, they were 6'5", 250. They had a couple of those guys. They had a lot of big physical running backs. Central Burden's Bo Savage was the best passing quarterback in potentially the history of eight-man football. So to slow him down and only allow 18 points to that explosive offense, it just shows me that Madison is so powerful. South Gray, it's good that they were able to get the late interception in that game over Osborne, a key victory, but it's important that they do something well early so that it doesn't get out of control.
He's John Betts. I'm James Westlean, and after the break, it's Madison and South Gray. Kickoff is coming up soon.
Presentation of the 8-man Division I Football Championship is brought to you in part by...
From Rural Telephone and Nextech. Providing the region with telephone, internet, cable television, and wireless phone solutions, Rural Telephone and Nextech proudly support public broadcasting and all ventures dedicated to improving Kansas communities.
American Lodge and Suites in Heston, offering a welcoming lobby with fireplace, 42 rooms including jacuzzi suites, indoor pool and spa, continental breakfast, and meeting room. American Lodge and Suites in Heston. Welcome to the end of the day.
Max Jantz Excavating, LLC of Montezuma, a contractor specializing in turnkey construction. From feedyard operations to ethanol plants, dairies, and wind farms, your project will be completed on time and within budget. Family-owned Madison Telephone, LLC, serving the Madison and Lamont areas for 65 years, supporting the Madison Bulldogs in athletics and academic endeavors. Montezuma State Bank, a proud sponsor of today's coverage of South Gray, and congratulations to the team on a great season. ADM of Montezuma and Copeland, thanking you for all your business and proud of the jobs our kids have done. Trevis Eatery of Madison, offering daily specials, fresh baked breads and desserts, deli sandwiches, and fried chicken dinners, and Sunday lunch. Dina Smith Accounting of Madison, for all your tax and accounting needs. Congratulating the Madison Bulldogs for making it to state. Borth Agency Incorporated of Montezuma, for your insurance needs. Not just your agent, your advocate. Information available at 800-501-7637. Shankey Well Service Incorporated, Madison. Citizen State Bank, Madison and Hamilton. Tricky Insurance of Copeland. Circle K Transport Incorporated of Copeland.
And welcome back to Fisher Field in Newton. Jeremy McGuire and Larry Jansen. And they're getting ready for the coin toss now, Larry. A lot of jitters out there on that field right now, I think, especially for the South Gray team.
Yeah, I think so. And they're just hoping that maybe they get the flip the coin here, maybe get the defer the second half, and we'll just see how it goes. But after the first hit or two, first series or two, it'll be just a regular old football game.
That's how it usually happens. You get the first couple plays, and we talked with Jeff Blattner off the air about how that's how he felt as well, that, you know, get a couple plays under their belt. And Madison has won the toss and has deferred to the second half, so South Gray will get the football to start things out. We're going to run down your starters first for the Rebels from South Gray. Colton Durst, number 8, a 6'1", 185-pound junior is an end. Ronald Martin's the other end. Number 3, a 6'1", 180-pound senior. The guards, number 70, Caleb Watts, a 5'10", 215-pound junior. Another guard, Joe Carter, a number 90, a 6-foot, 215-pound senior. And then number 22, Hunter Brown, the 5'8", 165-pound senior, anchors the middle of that line at center. At quarterback, Wyatt Slavin, a 6'1", 165-pound senior, 172 carries, 1,568 yards, and 33 touchdowns. The fullback, the bruiser, Luis Gallegos, 5'11", 190-pound senior. And the tailback is Coulter Croft, the 5'9", 170-pound senior. 220 carries, 2,352 yards, and 38 touchdowns. A young man that has accounted for well over half of the Rebels' points. On the defensive side for the Bulldogs, Colin Kyle and Dallas Thompson, defensive ends. Kyle, a 6'1", 190 senior. Thompson, a 6'1", 193 sophomore. Damien Gutierrez anchors the middle of the line at the nose guard, the 5'10", 212-pound senior. Cole Shankey and Tanner Bybee at the corners. Linebackers, Willie Derryberry and Bubba Smith. And the safety is Tyler Williams. Number 10, the 6'1", 158-pound senior. But a guy you'll hear a lot about defensively for the Bulldogs is Bubba Smith and Willie Derryberry. They get after it from their linebacker spots.
Absolutely. So we're going to see South Gray with the ball here, Jeremy, and the quarterback, and of course, Croft. They've had 71 out of 75 touchdowns all year. So here we go, getting ready.
We are set. Dallas Thompson will tee it up from the 30-yard line, and we are set to go from Fisher Field in Newton, and there is no way that ball is going to be returned as it goes off the crossbar. A pretty good wind at the back of Thompson, and we are set to go. It'll be first and 10 from the 15-yard line for the Rebels, our sub-state runner-up in 2005. That's as close as they've ever got to the state championship game. Madison really in their infancy as well, with their second state championship appearance.
And they're in their patented 3-2 defense right now, the Bulldogs.
And Savin Bates is in at a defensive end position and a little give up the middle. And not a whole lot going for Coulter Croft. He picks up 3 on the play. It's going to bring up 2nd down and 7.
The Bulldogs, of course, have the variations off of like a 3-2 monster, but that one there's just a straight running play right up the gut.
Now Thompson back in the DN position for the Bulldogs. 2nd and 7. Slavin in the shotgun. He's going to give it off the Croft left side, looking for a gap, and he is shoved out of bounds. Croft on the carry, brought out.
Tanner Bybee kind of helped on that tackle there, but gained about 2 yards, going to be third to about 5 yards, Jeremy. But that was a good team tackling by two or three of those old Bulldogs from Madison.
You can see how quickly Madison can get from sideline to sideline and get after a fast Croft. 3rd down and 5. Gallegos the fullback, and it's going to be Slavin. He's going to cut it back against the grain, and he's going to be ridden down hard by Shankey. After a pickup of 2 on the play, 3, it's going to bring up 4th down and 2.
All right, yeah, and that was a great job by Cole Shankey. Of course, he's anchored it last year. He's, of course, a heck of a running back when he got the ball, and he's going to soon probably have a punting situation here. What do you think? 4th and 1.
Jake Peters has come into the ball game. Number 42, a backup end, a 5'11", 210-pound freshman. Jeff Blattner says, let's take a chance early. 4th down and a short 2. They're going. It is Croft. He is going to have the 1st down. Not by much. He is upended on the play by Williams. Tyler Williams on the tackle, but a pickup of 2, and it's a 1st down and a gutsy call early by the South Gray Rebels.
But when they kick and start the game with a touchback and you move that ball just 10 yards right on the stripe, that's the length of the football, good. 1st down, move the sticks, huh?
And you got to think that Jeff Blattner was thinking about that fierce wind that's blowing into his team's face right now as well. Just under 10 minutes to go, first quarter, no score. two wide receivers. Slavens hands it off underneath and nowhere to go for Coulter Croft. He picks up a yard on the play, second and nine.
That didn't fool anybody on that there, at least which would be the Bulldogs up front. 66.
Willie Derryberry and Smith in on the tackle.
Bubba Smith, he said Willie Derryberry, he'll light it up. When I was talking to Coach early in the week, he said, just keep looking for Willie Derryberry.
Second and eight. There's a little counter action coming this way. Croft across the 30 up to the 31-yard line. They'll bring up third and four, so South Gray setting themselves up in makeable third down situations.
And they, of course, that was a good run there by him. He cut back in there, otherwise he would probably been stuck for a little no game. This way, what brings up third and probably four.
Third down and four, shotgun. Four wide receivers for the Rebels. They're trying to draw. It's going to be right side. Slavin, first down and then some, pushed out of bounds.
Tyler Williams got him out of bounds.
Williams on the tackle, but not before a pickup of seven and a Rebel first down.
That's a good job in there by Wyatt Slavin, the quarterback. Remember, they only passed 26 times and only connected on six the whole year, so this win ain't going to bother them at all today as far as the passing game, is it, Jeremy?
No, and you know that Madison's ready for that. Even though they spread so many guys out, the Bulldogs say, well, we'll force you to throw it if you really want to. Croft, right side, pushes his way forward. A nice surge by the offensive line and a pickup of 7 yards. Smith on the tackle for the Bulldogs.
That's what you call it. The jitters are now over. And now it's smash mouth football. Control the line of scrimmage.
And in South Gray, like you said, Larry, controlling the line of scrimmage, making sure they keep the football in their possession and out of the powerful Madison Bulldogs offense. Slavin, Croft, right side. He's going to have a first down, brought down at the 40. Shanky on the tackle for Madison. But a pickup of four on the play and a first down.
And a tackle there by Willie Derryberry, Tyler Williams, and Shanky. Three of them on that one there. But they're controlling that line of scrimmage. Of course, the three keys by Coach Blattner said control the line of scrimmage, sustain blocks, limit turnovers. And right now they're having fun going to their right side of the line. Over there behind that, Caleb Wea, Watts, and Ronald Martins.
Joe Carter and Colton Dirks are on the left side. They're going to go that way with Slavens looking to get to the corner. A nice kickout block by Watts on the pull, but brought down. Tanner Pivey in on the tackle. Also Gutierrez scooting down from his nose guard position, a pickup of two.
Yeah, and that was a great job because Tanner Bybee came from clear across the other side of the field, so that was great pursuit by him. They slowed him up, spread it out, and then he hadn't caught up with the play and then made that tackle there, Jeremy, for a very short gain of maybe 2 yards.
6:40 to go and counting here in the first quarter. So South Gray has nearly swallowed up half the quarter already, and they have a second and eight on the 28. There's a pitch to Croft, cuts it inside, Shanky on him. No gain on the play as Cole Shanky not only tackled him but ripped at that football like Fred McLean talked about in the pregame. No gain on the play, third and eight.
Yeah, as they called baby brother, trying to get that baby brother back. That's what the nickname they give to the ball.
Coulter Croft has carried the ball 8 times already in this first quarter unofficially for 24 yards.
Imagine that. Of course, coming into this game, he had 220 carries for 2,352 yards. 38 touchdown, so he's a bull for them. He carries the load.
Third down and eight. They're going to have to snap it. And the flag on the play. It is going to be a delay of game on South Gray, I believe. First penalty of the ball game.
Delay.
So instead of third and eight, now it's third down and 13, and that makes it awfully difficult for this team that, as we've mentioned several times, they've only passed the ball 26 times all year.
And only connected on six of them for 143 total yards. So they use it absolutely by an element of surprise, and there ain't no surprise here.
Third and 13, they go shotgun formation. They're going to throw it. Nope, Slavin is swallowed up in the backfield. He's going to lose 4 yards. Gutierrez in there. Also, Willie Derryberry. And it is fourth down and most likely a punting situation now for South Gray.
They know that South Gray loves to control the ball on the ground. And so they're going to have to prove otherwise if for them to get much respect on the passing game.
Croft back to punt it away. And he will put it in the air. Pretty decent punt, all things considered. It is going to take a nice Rebel bounce inside the 15 and down at the 10-yard line. So no points on that drive for South Gray that took up 7 minutes and 8 seconds on the clock. We're going to switch over. It's going to be Madison Bulldogs on offense, a team that has cranked out a ton of points in this football season. Smith and Thompson will get a start on the ends. Nick Young, number 54, a 6 foot, 272-pound junior at a guard, along with Matthew Glazer, a 6 foot, 181-pound junior. Hayden Serer, 5'10", 195-pound sophomore, will anchor things in the middle. Thompson is going to be at offset eye. Shanky back there with him. Cole Shanky with the first carry. And he is very patient with the football as Shanky gets out across the 15-yard line, a pickup of nearly 6 on the play.
He did a great job of following his blocks and just kind of trying to pick his hole like this. And, of course, Colin Kyle, he just rolled out his left-handed quarterback, which you'll see when he does pass the ball. But he just kind of had a nice little pitch out and went off the right guard and over the end. Made good yards. Second and 4, maybe, Jeremy.
Second down and 4 after the 6-yard gain by Shanky on first down. Shanky the lone setback with Bybee in motion. It is going to be Shanky. Look at him move. He's got a first down. Slavin on the tackle. That's a pickup of 7.
And he had a little hole there. He collapsed very good, but he did a great job, kind of like a spun. You see, after we got hit first, he spun away from it and still made another 3 yards.
That was a beautiful spin right there by Shanky to pick up a few extra. So first and 10 from the 23. Great to have you along for state championship football. There's a pitch to Shanky. Mishandled it for a moment. He's got a lead block. Shanky on the run. Cuts across the grain and finally brought down in South Gray territory at the 33-yard line. Colton Dirks on the tackle.
Well, that was what set that play up, was that head
34, and there's the run right there. Wow. 34 yards on the carry.
That was a great play there by Dallas Thompson, that sophomore. That's a tight end, also sent him run back. They had him in motion. They kicked that block out. And then, of course, he just cut underneath of it and made good yards into Jeremy.
Yes, he did. 24 yards on the carry, excuse me. My math was just a little bit too fast there. But Madison moving the ball. 3 carries, 37 yards already for Shanky. Of course, state championships and lots of yards. No stranger to him. He had 255 yards in the championship game against Hill City a year ago. He'll get it again. Running room again right up the gut, brought down on the play by Storm Mosier. Coming in from a cornerback position, Shanky picks up 4.
You know, and he runs to that hole sideways and still made good yards. Well, some of us who could run forwards and couldn't make those kind of yards. You know, but you see how he slivered right through there sideways and made 2 or 3 more yards before he got tackled.
Do what you got to do to get through.
That's
there.
Right. Absolutely. Great job by Cole Shanky, the 6'1", 192-pound senior.
Just under 3 to go. First quarter, no score. Bybee with a little motion. Now Colin Kyle with the keeper. Colton Dirks again on the tackle. Brought down at the 25-yard line. Third down and 2 after another 4-yard pickup. That's the first time somebody other than Cole Shanky has had the ball in their hands at the end of the play for Madison.
Well, Colton probably thought he needed a break. Give him a little breather that time.
Third down and a long 2 or a short 3. Either way you want to shake it. Here's the pitch to Shanky. He's got a lead blocker in Colin Kyle, and it's a first down. Down to the 18-yard line, a pickup of 7 on the play. Caleb Watts on the tackle. Hunter Brown slow to get up as he limps back to the defensive side of the football.
Yeah, he's still limping. They might have to take him out. I don't know. But that's a great job there by Tanner Bybee. He's put him in motion. He had a lead block, and he pitched it to their fast little running back, Cole Shanky.
A minute and 50 seconds and counting, first quarter. This is the first drive of the game for Madison. Shanky, right up the middle. He bulldozes his way inside the 15, down to the 12. 5 yards on, make it 6 on the play, second and 4. Nice block from Dallas Thompson to lead the way there.
He sure did. He did a great job. Number 23, 6 foot, 193-pound sophomore. Playing well beyond his years, being a sophomore, did a great job in that line.
One setback for the Bulldogs. Bybee in motion. Shanky up the middle. Nobody there. Shanky inside the 5, brought down at the 2. He is a tough one to bring down, folks.
Yeah,
11 yards and a first and goal for the Bulldogs.
And the Lion sure made a nice hole for him.
And look at him. I mean, he just lowers his shoulder, and good luck getting in the way of that. Coulter Croft is very slow to get up. He is going to need a little help off the field, and that is not what South Gray needs to see. You hope he's going to be all right, but he is their main power on offense. Defensively, their leading interceptor with 7 picks on the season. It'll be first and goal from the 3-yard line.
That's amazing where he had 7. He's had 7 interceptions this year and 56 tackles, that 5'9", 170-pound senior.
First and goal. Shanky right side. He's going to walk in for the touchdown. The Madison Bulldogs are on the board. A 3-yard run from Cole Shanky with 46.8 to go. First quarter, it's 6-0 Madison. And let the balloons fly.
And they will travel. Won't take them long to get to Heston and other places north. On a day like today, will it?
It should. Here comes a 2-point conversion attempt. Surprise, surprise, Shanky on the carry.
Imagine
and
that.
He is the in or not. No call from the official.
He crossed the line.
He is in. 2-point conversion is good. So after the 1 or 3-yard touchdown run, Shanky adds a 2-point conversion. And he was the machine on that drive, Larry Jantz.
Absolutely. He just did a great job. He just kind of steamrolled it all the way down there. He's a pretty tough old bulldog.
There's a run right there from Shanky for the touchdown. And again, a big hole. And I mean, Madison, you see what they do on the offensive line, but also the guys that come after that, the lead blockers, whether it's Kyle coming through or Bybee or Thompson, they really do a good job leading up through the hole.
Generally got some guy in motion. It kind of reminds you of some of the old flex bowling offense that way, doesn't it?
Sure does. Well, now South Gray is going to have to find an answer. And right now,
big question mark.
Coulter Croft still not out on the field. He's running down the sideline, though, warming up, so it looks like he's going to be able to come back in the ball game. But Slavin will go back deep for the Rebels. I highly doubt he's going to have a return after what Thompson did with the last kickoff.
They tried to hit it over the crossbar this time instead of just hitting on the crossbar.
Yeah. So it's 46.8 seconds left to go first quarter. It's an 8-0 Madison lead. Thompson will put that one in the air, and it is good.
Hit the lower crossbar, though.
Yeah, it still counts.
Oh.
So that one is through the end zone, a touchback, and we'll see if Croft, he is on his way back into the ball game. So Coulter Croft is in. Looks like he's moving around just fine, so that might be a sigh of relief.
For all the Rebel fans, huh, in the stands?
For the Rebel fans.
Plus Coach Blattner and Grant Salmons, the two coaches on the sideline.
First down and 10 from the 15. Croft left side, looking for a gap. Gutierrez stacks him up right at the line of scrimmage. He's able to push forward for a couple. Second down.
Yeah, that Damian Gutierrez said, you ain't got to have any of the part of this stuff here. We're going to give you 2 yards and that's it, buddy.
9 carries unofficially, 26 yards for Coulter Croft. Second down and 8 for the Rebels. And that clock winding down. I don't think they're going to have to snap it again here in this first quarter as we wind down to the end of the first quarter. As it winds down, it's been. It is the end of the first quarter. As you hear the unconventional whistle at the end of the first quarter. So we played one from Fisher Field in Newton. The defending state champion, Madison Bulldogs, on top of South Gray by a score of 8-0 here on Smoky Hills Public Television.
Presentation of the 8-man Division I football championship is brought to you in part by
from Rural Telephone and Nextech, providing the region with telephone, internet, cable television, and wireless phone solutions. Rural Telephone and Nextech proudly support public broadcasting and all ventures dedicated to improving Kansas communities.
American Lodge and Suites in Heston, offering a welcoming lobby with fireplace, 42 rooms including jacuzzi suites, indoor pool and spa, continental breakfast, and meeting room. American Lodge and Suites in Heston. Welcome to the end of the day.
Max Jantz Excavating, LLC of Montezuma, a contractor specializing in turnkey construction. From feed yard operations to ethanol plants, dairies, and wind farms, your project will be completed on time and within budget. Family-owned Madison Telephone, LLC, serving the Madison and Lamont areas for 65 years, supporting the Madison Bulldogs in athletics and academic endeavors. Montezuma State Bank, a proud sponsor of today's coverage of South Gray, and congratulations to the team on a great season. ADM of Montezuma and Copeland, thanking you for all your business and proud of the jobs our kids have done. Trevis Eatery of Madison, offering daily specials, fresh baked breads and desserts, deli sandwiches, and fried chicken dinners, and Sunday lunch. Dina Smith Accounting of Madison, for all your tax and accounting needs. Congratulating the Madison Bulldogs for making it to state. Shanky Well Service Incorporated, Madison. Citizen State Bank, Madison and Hamilton. Tricky Insurance of Copeland. Circle K Transport Incorporated of Copeland.
And welcome back to Fisher Field in Newton. Jeremy McGuire, Larry Jantz, and the entire Smoky Hills Public Television broadcast team bringing you the 8-man Division I state championship between the Madison Bulldogs and the South Gray Rebels. And Larry, that first quarter saw a lot of running the football. One possession for Madison, which ended up in a touchdown. A long possession for South Gray that ended up in a punt. And then one more play, and here we are to the second quarter. That was a fast-moving first quarter.
Absolutely. One of the fastest ones you'll probably see in the books for a long time. Of course, nobody was passing the ball with the wind the way it is late. But hey, the Madison Bulldogs, remember, they like to get turnovers, which they didn't have it yet, tackle well, and have read assignments and be real sound, do your own job. And they did do that. They controlled the line of scrimmage, at least there towards the later half of that first quarter.
Second down and 8 as we start the second quarter. Slavin's trying to keep Madison honest. And Croft on the run. He is hit by Gutierrez and Bubba Smith in on the tackle as well. A pickup of three. It will bring up third down and five.
Yeah, Croft weighs 170 pounds, and old Damon Gutierrez is 212, senior, 5'10", senior, number 98, nose guard for those Madison Bulldogs, and he kind of bulldogging down the ground.
Third down and five. Gallegos is the fullback. They would love to open up a hole here. They go right side. Croft has it. He's on the run. Look out. And he is pushed out of bounds. Smith over there on the sidelines to push him out, but a nice gain on the play up across the 30.
And a
Gallegos with a great lead block.
Absolutely. He did a great job. He's responsible for that, for Colder to get that first down. Absolutely. Great job by Lewis Gallegos. 5'11", 190-pound senior.
Look at it right there, and you saw Smith deck him out of bounds. But a pickup of 10 on the play and a big first down for South Gray, and they will continue this drive.
A much-needed first down, we might add.
Here's a counter coming this way for Slavin. Gets to the outside, picks up four as Bybee brings him down near the sidelines. It's second down and six.
Great individual job by Slavin that time. Of course, Tyler Williams helped on the tackle as well. 6 foot, 158-pound senior playing safety. Came up on his second down and a long five.
Croft again, up the middle, nowhere to go. Thompson, the first one to hit him. A gain of a yard on the play, third and five.
That sophomore is playing one heck of a game. Dallas Thompson, number 23, defensive end, 6 foot, 193 pound.
He's going to be a good one.
He's already
pretty decent right now, but he's going to be a good one. Second or third down and a long five for the Rebels.
And if he don't get you, Willie Derryberry's going to, or Bubba Smith.
They are an attacking defense. Gallegos with the carry, stacked up. He's able to lean forward to the 36-yard line. Thompson again in on the hit. A yard on the play, fourth and four.
Was he hearing you call his name out of time before, and he liked it so well, he thought, I'll get another tackle?
Tell you what, I think that young man is going to get a lot of tackles in his career.
Now we got fourth down long, so now we have a couple substitutions out there.
Punting situation now for South Gray. Be the second punt of the ball game with the wind behind him. Croft, a low snap, and he's going to get it away. It's a high kick, and it is going to bounce into the end zone for the touchback. Tyler Williams was there, said, I'm going to let this thing sail over my head, so it'll be first and 10 from the 15 as Madison forces the punt. As Gallegos looks a little winded out on the field right now, hands on the hip, kind of leaning over with 9:27 to go first half. Well, Cole Shankey on the first drive, 8 carries, 68 yards, and a touchdown. See how he does with drive number two. It is going to be calling Kyle over to the outside, and he is hit and dropped. Caleb Watts leading the way for South Gray. Gallegos in there as well. No gain, second and 10.
Caleb Watt, boy, he hit him. 5'10", 250-pound junior. Had 58 tackles this year, an interception, had a fumble recovery, and 3 sacks. Number 70, defensive end for the South Gray Rebels, did a great job on that play. Stayed home, kept his position.
Second and 10 from the 15. South Gray would love to force Madison into a punting situation deep in the Bulldogs' territory. Shankey hit, dropped. Good job.
Good ankle
Hunter
tackle.
Hunter Brown in there at the ankles brings down Shankey, third down and 8.
Good old linebacker there for the South Gray Rebels, Hunter Brown, 5'8", 165-pound senior. Had 138 tackles for the year, 2 interceptions, and 3 fumble recoveries, and he showed you why he's had such a great year.
And I don't know if you guys were able to see that. You saw Colin Kyle come to the sideline just a little bit, and Fred McLean just yells the play out to him. So here it comes, whatever it was, third down and eight. And it's a inside handoff. Shanky going to the outside hit, and he's going to be short of the first down, I believe. No, he's going to get it. They give him a left foot spot. It is a first down and a pickup of 8 yards.
Rodney Palin over there from Beloit America on that spot, the old zebra. He had it marked perfectly.
First and 10 from the 25, a wraparound draw for the Bulldogs on that play. First down and 10. There's a pitch to Shanky. Comes outside, and a near strip by Croft.
He tried to get a strip, didn't he?
But Gallegos came in and finished him off, a pickup of 10 and another first down. Seven and a half minutes to go, first half. Madison with the football and an 8-0 lead. They're nearing midfield.
In motion is Bybee.
Shanky in the open field, brought down. Slavin on the tackle, a pickup of 7 on the play.
Tackle by Slavin.
Great blocking up front by Bubba Smith, opening up a hole. And there you see him going right there. Second down and 3.
That was a great job on that little slant play. With a great tackle there by Wyatt.
Madison is exerting themselves right now. Second and 3 is... Thompson takes a step back. Shanky with the carry in the open. And Croft hangs on for dear life down to the 26-yard line. A pickup good enough for a first down. Pickup of 12.
That all motion offense has done pretty good job for the Bulldogs. The number one offense, you said, would be Wing T. Oh.
Saw that run there by Shanky. Tell you what, he gets in the open, and Coulter Croft just got a hold of that thing and that jersey and just hung on for dear life. First down and 10. There's Shanky again. Down to the 21-yard line. Nick Young and Bubba Smith leading the way.
And Storm Mosier in there. He's probably got him first, a 5'900-pound senior. At 58 tackles this year, one interception, fumble recovery. Number 4, Storm Mosier from the Southbury Rebels. But you notice the offense for the Bulldogs, they use an offensive set. Wing T is a primary, then a balanced wing T, and then a lot of motion to the third different set.
Love to bring motion, try and confuse the defense. There's some of that motion right there. Lots of lead blocks for Shanky, gets hit. Brought down around the 16-yard line. Hunter Brown in on the hit for the Rebels. And that is going to be enough for first down. Pick up a 6 on the play. Fifteen carries, 117 yards and a touchdown. This is only the second drive of the ball game for Madison. They lead 8-0. There's 5 minutes to go in the first half. Only time the ball's been in the air is on kickoffs and punts. From the 15-yard line, Shanky dropped in the backfield. Colton Dirks leading the way. He got the penetration and the tackle, a loss on the play of 1, and it's not very often, Larry Jantz, that you hear loss on the play when Cole Shanky runs the football.
You're absolutely right. But due to Colton Dirks' great job there at defensive end, he's had 120 tackles all year long, 3 sacks for the 6'1", 185-pound junior. Colton Dirks, great job by the old Rebel.
Second down and 11, a substitution. Carson Skidmore comes in. Mosher out. There's a pitch. They're coming right at Skidmore. Shanky lowers his shoulder.
And Carson Skidmore got in there for a tackle along with number 24.
Gallegos in there as well. Pickup of 8 yards, third and three. And we are going to have a timeout on the field. So a 3:52 to go, a timeout on the field. We'll keep it here, Larry. I'll tell you what, Madison, even though they only have one touchdown on the board, just methodically moving the ball down the field, and South Gray having a hard time getting the stops when they need them.
They just keep chipping away at it, you know, chipping away, chipping away, chipping away. They're wearing down. I think the Rebels are getting wore out when you spend that much time on defense after these sustained drives. Of course, that's what Madison wanted to do. They wanted to kind of, you know, keep the chains moving, take care of the ball, and they've been doing a good job of that. And so far, so well for Coach McLean and the Madison Bulldogs.
In South Gray, as you mentioned, getting a little fatigued defensively, and that's when it gets real tough, when you have a team like Madison just drilling the ball at you time after time after time. It gets a little tough out there eventually.
Yeah, stopping for short gains once or twice, you know, in a row, two yards, 3 yards, 4 yards, then all of a sudden spring that 12 and 15 yarder against you, and then we keep that chains moving, and that's tough to recuperate from that.
So it will be third down and three. The ball on the 8 yard line. 3:52 to go, first half. The defending state champion Bulldogs on top, 8-0.
And on the drive,
Thompson and Shanky split in the backfield. It is Shanky up the middle. He's going to be just short of the first down, I believe.
That depends on the spot.
A couple on the play. Near side spot shows him about a half a yard short of the first down, maybe a yard short. He has to get all the way down to the 5 for a first down, and a big play coming up for the South Gray defense.
But Coach Fred McLean has set the play in the Colin Kyle, who came over there, and now it's fourth down and a yard, and there won't be much trickery on this one.
Yeah, you got to figure that it's going to be smash mouth right up the gut. And it is Kyle, and I believe he's got it. He picked up a yard on the play right into the middle of that defense, right over the top of Hayden Sayre for the first down, a pickup of one, first and goal.
Tackle in there by Hunter Brown, their leading tackler for the South Gray Rebels.
First down and goal from just inside the 5 yard line. Joe Carter pacing it from his nose guard position, getting ready for the next play on this drive. And it is Shanky. No, it's going to be Kyle keeps it. A good play action there. And from 5 yards out, Colin Kyle into the end zone for the Madison Bulldogs with 2:47 to go in the first half. It is 14-0 Madison. And a good play fake as Dirks, I thought, had control of the play with Shanky, but he didn't have the football.
It's just a great read by Colin Kyle, the quarterback, when he saw that. Hey, just pulled the ball out of his gut and went on there for now they'll go for two. That's his sixth touchdown all year long. On the running side, he's had 62 carries for 338 yards and 5 touchdowns. Make it 6 now with Colin Kahn. Here we go for the two-point extra point.
And here comes Shanky. He is going to walk in for the two-point conversion. No flags on the play. 2:47 to go first half. Madison 16, South Gray nothing. The Rebels are going to have to find some kind of an answer because right now Madison controlling the line of scrimmage, and that's something that South Gray wanted to do, as you see Kyle into the end zone easily on the play action, and now South Gray really needs to answer because Madison gets the football to start the second half. Only 2:47 to go here in the first half.
And we know South Gray doesn't like to put the ball in the air, or at least they haven't done it through all their games so far this year. So it'll be interesting to see here.
Madison fans cheering in the wind. It is a windy day here at Fisher Field in Newton. It is sunny. There is no snow, there is no sleet, there is no rain, though. So on November 19th, I think we'll take it. Now we'll see what kind of effect this wind has as Madison kicks into the wind. If you're the Bulldogs, do you maybe do an onside kick here? I'd look out for an onside kick myself, but that's the video game player in me coming out. You know, take any chance you want. But this is for real right now.
Oh, I think he's got to kick a little bit into that breeze, that strong breeze. I imagine it'll flutter in the air a little bit, don't you?
I would think so. Colter Croft is back at his own five. Thompson set to kick it away.
Oh, did you see it go off the tee?
It rolled off the tee before it had a chance to get it kicked.
Good thing he didn't hyperextend his knee on that one.
I think somebody called the onside kick, didn't they?
Well, yeah, but the wind gods is out there doing it.
I'll take it anyway.
It wasn't Coach McLean, I can tell you that.
Well, with that wind blowing, it is blowing right in the face of the football. So now you got to figure that the front four for South Gray are a little bit more aware of the potential of that football coming at them.
Be another good use for some duct tape on that ball and that tee.
But there's a line drive. It is going to be picked up by Coulter at about the 15. Looking for a little bit of a gap and push back at the 27, 28-yard line. First down there for South Gray. 2:40 to go in the first half.
It's a great job how he slivered through there and got an extra 5-8 yards before they brought him to the turf.
First down and 10. And we'll mark it at the 27-yard line. Fast, fast, fast moving first half. 16-0 Bulldogs. They're going to throw it. Slavin looking to throw. Rolls to his right. Pump fakes. He's still on his feet, and he is when he slung out of bounds and a flag on the play. That might be a hold against Gallegos, just depending on what to say. Pick up a 10, but hold on.
I think they're going to get that fullback for South Gray for a hold there after play, which puts this time Slavin.
Gets the offense.
Yep. Good call, Jeremy. That's what happened.
So a pickup of, well, they'll mark it from the spot. So after the five yards behind the line of scrimmage, they'll back it up. It'll be first and 15. First and 15, Slavin in the shotgun. And he is going to keep it as he looks right side, looks for a gap, hit and dropped. A short pickup on the play of 3 yards. It's second down and 12. South Gray is having a real hard time. Caleb Watts is getting back to the line of scrimmage, having a discussion with the official on the near side.
Well, he ain't going to win that battle. That's Ron Hague. Yeah.
Ron will hold his ground.
Oh, Ron Hague, he hang right in here.
Second and 12. They're going to throw it this time. Wyatt over the middle has a man. Gallegos makes the catch. Up across the 30 to the 31. Picks up 6 on the play. Brings up third down and 6.
They need another duplication of that play there. Need another 6 or 7 yards, and so they can keep the sticks going and control that line of scrimmage a little bit, and South Gray could use a little of that.
Rebels throwing the ball a couple times on this drive already. They're looking to throw the ball. They threw it once, and Slavin ran it once when they got the holding penalty. And it's going to be Slavin looking left, goes back to the right, nowhere to go, and he is pushed forward out to the 31-32. Gutierrez again on the tackle, a pickup of 1 on the play. It's fourth down for the Rebels.
Timeout by the Madison Bulldogs.
Timeout for Madison with 1 minute to go here in the first half. And do you dare take the chance if you're Jeff Latner to go for it on fourth and five at this point?
No, I don't think I would. I'd punt the thing out and make them have to go the length of the field. Right now, if they failed to make the first down, then they got a short field with that minute to go, and it with Shank and Kyle in the backfield with Bybee and all their motion stuff, it wouldn't take long for them to maybe add another score to their board. And I don't think South Gray don't need that.
See what Jeff Latner decides to do with his South Gray team, because they're in kind of a precarious situation, down by 16. So we mentioned that Madison gets the ball to start the second half. The only two drives of the ball game that Madison has had it, they've moved 70 yards for a touchdown and 55 yards for a touchdown.
And so you don't want to give the ball to them again, not at a short deal. I'd say with a minute to go in the halftime, let's punt it right. Make them go the whole distance. And I think that's what Coach Blattner decided to do.
Make that 65 yards for a touchdown. Well, that will punt the football away. Croft gets it. He gets the punt. Going towards the out-of-bounds line. And it's just going to depend on where the official spotted on that far side.
10, 11, 12.
They're going to put it at the 12-yard line. So Madison has 68 yards to go and 54.8 seconds. So we'll see what they have in the old playbook to move that far. Two touchdown drives so far for the Bulldogs. Defensively, we'll see what South Gray tries to do.
Well, they better play some smash mouth line play.
There's the pitch to Shanky, looking for the lead, gets to the sideline and is going to be brought down.
Croft
on the tackle, Dirks coming over as well. Kyle a little slow getting up. It's second down and five after the 5 yard gain for Cole Shanky. Security! 30 seconds to go, first half.
They're going to just be content to control the ball and let halftime get here, I think.
There's a reverse to Tyler Williams, and he got hammered. Storm Mosier on the tackle.
Absolutely. Did a great job, that 5'9", 190-pound senior. Storm Mosier, number four. Had 58 tackles so far up this year. Added another one to it right there. And an interception and a fumble recovery.
And that is going to be the final play of the first half. It's a first half dominated by the Madison Bulldogs. First two drives, touchdowns. Drive number three, Larry Jantz. The end of the half. That's pretty good offense.
The clock stopped them on that one.
So the clock stopped them there, but right now they are looking well on their way to their second consecutive 8-man Division I state championship. We are at halftime. It's Madison on top of South Gray by a score of 16-0. We'll be back with your second half after this on Smoky Hills Public Television.
Hello, I'm Gary Musselman, Executive Director of the Kansas State High School Activities Association. We hope you are enjoying this broadcast of Kansas High School Championship Football. For many Kansas youth, participation in sports and activities plays a major role in their educational experience. Many of the young people you see performing on the field of competition excel in the classroom as well. The mission of our state's high school association is to help prepare Kansas students for life, work, and post-secondary education through a well-balanced experience. Whether they are on the team, in the band, leading cheers for their school, or supporting their fellow students in the stands, it is our hope these experiences will create memories they will remember for the rest of their lives. Today's game is a reminder that hard work and dedication pays off on the field and in the classroom. Thank you for watching and supporting the young people of Kansas. Enjoy the rest of the game.
Presentation of the 8-man Division I football championship is brought to you in part by...
From Rural Telephone and Nextech, providing the region with telephone, internet, cable television, and wireless phone solutions, Rural Telephone and Nextech proudly support public broadcasting and all ventures dedicated to improving Kansas communities.
American Lodge and Suites in Heston, offering a welcoming lobby with fireplace, 42 rooms including jacuzzi suites, indoor pool and spa, continental breakfast, and meeting room. American Lodge and Suites in Heston. Welcome to the end of the day.
Max Jantz Excavating, LLC of Montezuma, a contractor specializing in turnkey construction. From feed yard operations to ethanol plants, dairies, and wind farms, your project will be completed on time and within budget. Family-owned Madison Telephone, LLC, serving the Madison and Lamont areas for 65 years, supporting the Madison Bulldogs in athletics and academic endeavors. Montezuma State Bank, a proud sponsor of today's coverage of South Gray, and congratulations to the team on a great season. ADM of Montezuma and Copeland, thanking you for all your business and proud of the jobs our kids have done. Trevis Eatery of Madison, offering daily specials, fresh baked breads and desserts, deli sandwiches, and fried chicken dinners, and Sunday lunch. Dina Smith Accounting of Madison, for all your tax and accounting needs. Congratulating the Madison Bulldogs for making it to state. Borth Agency Incorporated of Montezuma, for your insurance needs. Not just your agent, your advocate. Information available at 800-501-7637. Shanky Well Service Incorporated, Madison. Citizen State Bank, Madison and Hamilton. Tricky Insurance of Copeland. Circle K Transport Incorporated of Copeland.
It's a big week this week. The president has really come around.
I've got two sound bites.
Okay, so Alexis will talk about what?
Tim Kaine was talking about.
But the point is that they've been pulling their punches. I mean,
the whole politics of what's going on in Washington right now.
But what are the words we won? Let's just start with what we saw was playing out. But
illustrated.
Our eyes was the exact opposite.
Oh, yeah, I got to get that done.
Right.
Washington.
What time's Dennis coming?
4:30.
Okay.
It's your economy.
Your health.
Your environment.
Your country.
And it's your choice for president. Need to Know, covering the issues that matter to you most.
Friday at 7:30 on Smoky Hills Public Television.
You still have one last chance. Just one would show just why they are ranked number one. St. John would make the match go really quick. And then gold, putting up for you one above Garden City. Grainfield for Wheatland Cross Country Invitational.
Well, it was loaded. Some of those weight classes just had so many good kids. In fact,
look at that. He's got just with one arm. Now he's got a little bit in there. He picks up the ball.
Sasha, this kind of game, we watched a huge flush on the finish by Boringham through two defenders on the floor. So many things had to go.
I'm Jeremy McGuire along with Larry Jantz and Larry Calvary.
With all our viewers, 90% watch. And only 10% support. Become a member of Smoky Hills Public Television today.
This guy came up. I didn't know who he was. He had on a plaid shirt and a baseball cap, and I was thinking, well, you know, he's a little too smart to be homeless. And he said, I want to buy this art. And his name was Rene DeRosa.
He was buying art like a madman.
It just happened little by little, and I filled the house, and I couldn't stop buying it. This is a piece that can be touched. So that's art you can kick.
When you shop PBS, you're discovering the world of television's best history and science programs. You can journey through America's past with Ken Burns, explore the universe with Nova, or meet the presidents with American Experience. And every purchase you make helps PBS share these experiences with everyone. So whether it's a Ken Burns classic or science from Nova, you can explore new worlds and ideas when you shop PBS.
They're calling it a national disaster. Extensive flooding at the National Gallery.
The underground facility is still there in North Wales.
They're hiding paintings down there.
Are they really?
Hey, hello!
There must be some kind of misunderstanding.
Art is for people who appreciate it.
Well, I think that you don't understand any of these paintings at all.
On Masterpiece Contemporary.
Sunday at 8 on Smoky Hill Public Television.
What could be better than Antiques Roadshow?
Can't imagine.
How about two Antiques Roadshows?
No way.
You're joking.
Get ready for twice the treasure.
Wow.
Two times the fun.
Really?
I'm stunned.
Double the excitement.
Woo-hoo! Oh, my goodness.
With back-to-back episodes of Antiques Roadshow Monday nights.
Really?
I'm not making that up.
Every Monday comes with a matching pair of Antiques Roadshow.
That's exciting.
Thank you.
The sigh of the weary. Hard times.
Pledge $50 to Smoky Hills Public Television today, and you will receive two tickets to see the Celtic Tenors in Salina on December 9th. Contact Melinda for more information. Pledge today.
Our goal here on Doctors on Call is to bring you information which may be useful to you when you see your own physician.
Then we make a small incision in the armpit, and using those techniques, we're able to identify this first lymph node, or sometimes there's two or three lymph nodes.
But there are a number of protocols that use high-dose intravenous vitamin C for managing certain malignancies.
Because there's no cookbook. Let the physician use his judgment.
Absolutely.
And his experience.
Yes.
Wednesday nights, Nova and Brian Greene unlock the secrets of the universe. First, explore the frontiers of time and space in Nova's all-new The Fabric of the Cosmos. Then, the series critics call mind-blowing television. A special encore of The Elegant Universe. The Fabric of the Cosmos and The Elegant Universe. Back-to-back on Nova.
Wednesday at 8 on Smoky Hills Public Television.
It's easy to spot people who participated in high school sports and activities.
Right on time.
They learned important lessons like leadership, teamwork, respect.
Hey, our meeting moved to 10.
We'll be ready.
Values that last a lifetime.
We need to focus on three factors.
Support high school sports and activities in your community. When kids take part, they get set for life.
And welcome back to Fisher Field in Newton. Jeremy McGuire along with color analyst Larry Jantz on Smoky Hills Public Television. The Kansas State High School Activities Association 8-man Division I state championship game. The Madison Bulldogs with the 16-0 lead over the South Gray Rebels. Looking at the statistics from the first half for the Bulldogs, 8 first downs in the first half, 24 carries, 143 yards. They did not throw a pass in the first half and ended the second quarter on when the clock ran out on their third drive of the ball game. They have not lost any fumbles. They have not committed any penalties. On the other side of the football for the South Gray Rebels, 4 first downs, 22 carries, 62 yards. 6 yards passing for a total of 68 yards. They were 1-for-1 passing the football, no fumbles, and they had 2 penalties for 15 yards in the ball game, a holding penalty that held them back a little bit, and their last drive ended up
They weren't able to get the first down, had to punt the football away. First drive of the ball game for the South Gray Rebels. They took the ball on their own 15-yard line, drove it all the way into Madison territory, took over 7 minutes off that first quarter clock, but ended up having to punt the football away. Well, when they punt the football away, Madison took it and went 70 yards from their own 10-yard line. The two-point conversion run by Cole Shankey. They led it 8-0 at the 46-second mark of the first quarter. And in the second quarter, a 65-yard drive capped off by a 5-yard touchdown run from Colin Kyle. The two-point conversion run by Cole Shankey and made it 16-0 at that point. And Larry Jantz, Madison gets the football to start the second half. And if their offense can move the ball down the field and score another touchdown, it is going to be awfully difficult for South Gray to get back in this game.
Especially since South Gray dislikes the passing game so much, but they're going to be forced into it. And with the factor of the wind in there like this, if Madison can sustain the drive, keep doing what they're doing, they're going to wear them out because the South Gray defense has been on the field way too long.
Cole Shankey last year, 255 yards in the championship game as a junior against a Good Hill City squad. That was an awesome championship game last year. This year, 131 yards on 19 carries and a touchdown and a couple two-point conversions. He is a tough one to stop.
Well, Madison has had 90 rushing TDs this year, 24 passing touchdowns, 39 two-point extra points, 17 one-point extra points kicking them. And they've held opponents to only 104 points in 12 games. So they only allow 8.6 points scored by their opponents. And they've held half of their team scoreless for the whole year, Jeremy. So their offensive stats is incredible. On offense, they had 427 total possessions or snaps and over 4,354 total yards. They average 10 yards every time that they take a snap, pass or run.
As Larry mentioned, half their opponents held scoreless. Madison defense held six opponents scoreless. They held Hartford to only 6 points. And then a couple times in the playoffs, in the opening rounds, they held Rock Hills to 8 points. And then in the sub-state victory over Downs Lakeside, they hold them to 6 points. Their biggest defensive letdown, I guess, this year was at Levo when they allowed Levo to score 44 points and then a 22-point output on October 7th. And it is awful tough to score against that defense.
Yep.
Awful tough.
We stacks those two linebackers, that's pretty tight. It's almost like a five-man line because he's got a 3-2, but those linebackers are they're ready to stunt and they're ready to pounce on the ball wherever it's at. And they do a great job. They're reading the two middle inside linebackers on a 3-2, Bubba Smith and Willie Derryberry, because they're crowding the line, scrimmage almost. It's close to looking like a five-man line, but it's not.
And they're extremely active. And, you know, when you have guys that are, you know, 5 men in the box, that means 3 men in coverage, they're just daring you to throw the football. And like we've said, that is not South Gray's bread and butter.
It's not
their
forte.
They want to run the football, but it might get to the point, like you said, where if they want to break this defense, crack it a little bit, they're going to have to start throwing it.
And then that could turn ugly if the ball gets intercepted, then it should be more that way. So, because they only had 6 of the 26 passes coming into this year completed, and that's only 23%. So they have not had to rely on the passing game, probably what tells me most, because that Slavin, he's a good quarterback. I think he's probably got a good arm. He threw a real good pass, that one that was completed early in the first half. I was impressed by it. And he's a great athlete. Got a lot of relatives up the road from Montezuma, South Gray country, in a little town called Cimarron. The Slavin kid does Wyatt.
So South Gray will be kicking to start the second half. As Carson Skidmore, the freshman, will tee it up at the 30-yard line. And here you might think about an onside kick possibly, but that ball's going to have a hard time staying on the tee.
Carson Skidmore, you might recall in 1A basketball, his older sister, Michaela Skidmore. South Gray Rebels, they've won the state championship. That's his older sister. They're playing Juco ball at Garden City. Grandpa Gary Skidmore and Dad's Jeff. Well, it's not every day a freshman gets to play in a state game, but New York right here is ready to kick off. Carson Skidmore, number 10 for South Gray Rebels.
And he gets into one. It's going to be a short one. It bounces and goes out of bounds at the 10-yard line. And it is going to be Madison football. So not the kick that Skidmore wanted right there, but it's going to be first down and 10 for the Bulldogs as we start this second half. Jeremy McGuire, Larry Jantz, bringing you high school football along with the entire crew from Smoky Hills Public Television. Glad you're able to sit in and enjoy the final weekend of eight-man football for 2011. Kyle under center. And it's a pitch to Shanky. Coming near side. He's got a block. Looks up the field. Watts on the tackle. Up near midfield. Bubba Smith leading the way along with Nick Young. That's a big pickup on first down.
Yeah, and Kayla Watts coming in. But man, that was a great kick-out block by 23.
Look at it right here. Just watch it. You saw Thompson with the kick-out that you mentioned, Larry, and Shanky for 15 yards on first down.
Yeah, Dallas Thompson was responsible for that there because he knocked Coulter Croft out towards the sideline, and of course Cole Shankin and his swiftness just cut up underneath of it.
First and 10 from midfield. There's Shankey again, hit early. Hunter Brown in there again.
Good job.
Leading the charge for the Rebels. No gain on the play.
Hunter Brown, of course, he's a leading tackler all year long. 138 tackles for that South Gray Rebel. Two interceptions, three fumble recovers, a couple block pass attempts, and that's not too bad, by golly, for a 5'8", 165-pound senior linebacker for the Rebels.
Second down and a long nine or a short 10, about a half a yard gained on that play from Shanky. They're going left side this time.
They fill the gap.
South Gray was filling the gap. Shanky is able to squeeze out for a pickup of four on the play. Gallegos misses the tackle, but then finished up by Dirks at the 36-yard line.
There's either two or three Rebels didn't wrap him up, and he squirted loose, like you said, for a gain of about three, 4 yards.
There it is right there. And Shanky picks up four when it looked like he was going to be shut down for nothing.
We're going to have timeout by Fred McLean and Madison Bulldogs.
Timeout by Madison. We'll keep it here. 10:25 to go. Third quarter, 16-0 Bulldogs, and a third down and six for Madison. So South Gray showing some aggressiveness defensively. They're going to have to attack the line of scrimmage and attack those lead blockers for Madison because, you know, 5, 6, 7 yards of carry is going to hurt them.
Well, their normal defensive set is a 3-4-1. But they're going to have to squeeze them linebackers up there, almost do like what Madison's doing to them, like almost give a five-man look, get somebody up in the box, and then cover every gap.
Force them to throw the football if you absolutely have to.
Absolutely.
I mean, if that's their strength, you got to force the running game. You got to force them to do something they don't like to do. But
and
it's awful hard. I mean, you can say that. But it's awfully hard to get a team like Madison out of the rhythm. But South Gray is a good enough football team and experienced enough that they have an opportunity to do it.
Yeah, but the Bulldogs have a good balance. I mean, you know, Colin Klein, he's had passed the ball 78 times and connected on 49 of them for almost 1,000 yards, average 19.5 yards per every pass.
Third down and six for the Bulldogs. Colin Kyle under center. There's Shanky up the middle. He is stacked up. He's going to get maybe one on the play. Colton Dirks, the first one in there. Gallegos also had some help to finish it off.
It was a great job by the Rebels that time.
Pickup of a yard on the play. It looks like Madison's going to punt the football.
For the first time today, huh?
That is what the doctor ordered for the Rebels.
That almost blocked.
Carter tipped it, and it's going to be down at the 23-yard line. Carter got his hand on it, tipped it away, and it's going to be first down and 10 at the South Gray 23-yard line. So exactly what South Gray needed, Larry. They needed a defensive stop. They've got it. Now the offense has to produce. Not much going for him in that first half, though.
We'll see what kind of adjustments Coach Blattner and Grant Salmons, the two coaches, the brain trust for the South Bay Rail, we'll see what kind of choices or changes they made here at halftime, adjustments.
Only 68 yards of offense in the first half. Slavin's going to the right side, tries to get the outside. Shakey says, no way. A loss on the play of 3 yards. It is going to bring up second down and 13. Shanky just kept, you know, you, as a defender, you always want to keep that outside arm free. You don't want anybody to get outside of you. He did a good job there and forced Slavin's.
Well, I think when you saw the, you know, you had twins split to the left, twin to the right, and only one back, the quarterback back there. He needs to open it up more. They're spreading out the field, but they're not fooling anybody.
Second and 13. He's going to go left side this time. A little bit of room, but not much. Gutierrez and Thompson there. Pickup of 2 on the play. Third and 11.
They're not sustaining the blocks, and that was one of the things Coach Blattner said what they had to do, control the line of scrimmage and also sustain blocks. That time there wasn't very, the last two times there wasn't any sustaining blocking going on.
Caleb Watts got blown up on that play. But it's awful easy to do when you're going up against the 212-pound Gutierrez and 193-pound Thompson. Slavin to throw the football, looking to his left, in some trouble. He's going to set up, goes down the field, has a man open.
Oh, yeah.
Caught by Coulter. Coulter Croft, the first down at the 34-yard line.
Now, there's a prescription that got filled properly by the pharmacist.
23 yards and a first down.
Yes, sir. The Dr. Blattner over there wanted that. Look at there.
Look at Slavin escape and then had Coulter Croft wide open.
You're going to see more of that, I got a feeling. More passing plays into the strategy, huh?
I would think so.
Going to have to be.
Look at Gutierrez go after Hunter Brown. He is still reeling a little bit. Throw down the middle, man open.
Yes!
He's touchdown!
And there
That's
you go.
That's the way to do it. The Rebels are on the board. 34-yard touchdown pass to Coulter Croft. And with 8:23 to go in the third quarter, we have ourselves a ball game.
All right.
Wow, what a play. And a beautiful pass by Slavin.
Is that a tight spiral?
That is only his third touchdown pass on the season.
It couldn't have come at a better time, my friend. We're going for 2-point extra point here. There they go.
To make it a one-possession ball game. Slavin looking. Gonna roll to his left under some pressure. Throws it back across. It's incomplete. And it is a 16-6 ball game. So a 34-yard connection between Wyatt Slavin and Coulter Croft. And with 8:23 to go, Larry Jantz, here in the third quarter, South Gray strikes. There's that ball in the air. And Croft does a great job bringing that in for the touchdown. And now South Gray, who didn't have any momentum in that first half, they have it on their side right now.
Yeah, they took the crowd out off those off that EMT machines over there. There's new life over there for them guys in the crowd, the South Gray Railroad Rebels.
Now
they were kind of lethargic earlier, I think.
And defensively, they have to have a little bit of momentum as well. After
absolutely.
Stopping Madison, forcing them to punt the ball.
As we said earlier, this is the first time for the South Gray Rebel football team to be in a state championship format. But in the other game, the round one, the bounce a little bit better than this one. They've been many times up the Hayes in Class 1A basketball. Many state championships, runner-up, and a lot of times in there, and guys and gals basketball. So good athletic tradition down there at South Gray Rebel Country.
And Skidmore kicks that one away. It's a line drive taken by Bybee at the 3. Coming up the field, looking for a gap, and is going to be brought down as he gets up to the 24-yard line. Brown on the tackle.
That was a pretty good kick by that freshman, wasn't it? Huh?
Nice line drive. They'll mark it at the 25. That's where Madison will start.
I expect his sister, Michaela, taught him ever how to do that. I don't think it'd be his dad, Jeff, or his grandpa, Gary. I don't think they could ever kick the ball that far.
First down and 10. And here comes...
Oh, that's a great job.
Shanky, and he's dropped by Dirks. Gallegos was there. Croft was there. A pickup of a yard on the play, and all of a sudden, South Gray attacking that line of scrimmage.
Well, what's different in that play there? Most of the time, either Thompson or Bybee's been kicking Croft out of the play, and then they cut underneath that. But this time, you had number eight. You had old...
Colton Dirks.
You had him filling that gap, and he did very well.
And a pass. Kyle
fumbles the ball, and Carter has it for the Rebels.
A fumble on the play, and it's first down and 10 South Gray. And speaking of South, things going south right now for the Bulldogs.
Yeah, we have a ball game in on 23-yard line. Now South Gray is 23 yards away from Pater.
So a fumble on the play, the first turnover of the ball game, and now South Gray is knocking on the door again. We'll see how Hunter Brown does. Looks like he has a bad ankle. Gutierrez has been handling him. Right side Crops. He's going to have a yard or two on the play. And it's going to bring up second down.
And never old 23, Dallas Thompson. They're good for another good old tackle. Told him for very little gain, about a yard.
Second down and eight. Watch that matchup with Hunter Brown and Damian Gutierrez. Center, nose guard. Right side Croft has a little bit of a seam. Williams, Gutierrez on the tackle up on, at the 17-yard line.
Third and long three, huh? That's a great job in there, but... Yeah, Hunter Brown and those center for the Rebels, and Damian Gutierrez, that nose guard for the Bulldogs.
You look at it, a bad ankle and a 50-pound weight difference. Slavin looks to the outside, throws it over the middle,
it's caught! Another touchdown, Ronald Martins! From 17 yards out! It is 16-12, and who would have thunk it? The passing game getting the Rebels back in this thing.
Absolutely, and that was one of the few times that you didn't see good tackling because two guys from Madison could have wrapped him up and kept him out of the end zone. But he broke loose because of the, Coach McClain would probably say, improper tackling strategies or technique.
Slavin had a chance to get to the outside. And he did. Here comes the two-point conversion attempt. Back to pass. Looks over the middle. Sets up. Goes to the outside. Dumps it in. It is intercepted. I think he might have been able to run that one in.
I think so, too.
He tried to soft toss into the end zone. It was no good, but... South Gray gets on the board again. The Rebels following the Madison fumble right here. Slavin rolls to his left, throws it up. Martins in coverage, makes the catch into the end zone for the Rebel touchdown with 6:08 to go in the third quarter. It is 16-12, Larry Jantz.
We got a ball game now. Which we thought if they didn't come back to South Gray here in the third quarter, could be a long afternoon for the Rebels. But by golly, now we got a heck of a slobbering off our hitting game, man. Well, line of scrimmage. We're going to find out who's going to control the line of scrimmage now.
And you also have to look at it from a standpoint of, it looked like South Gray defense was really on their heels the entire first half. So far here in the first 5 minutes and 52 seconds of the second half, Madison has been on its heels offensively and defensively.
And defensively now, Jeremy, for the Rebels, they've been still kicking out Croft. You know, they're getting that kick-out block, you know, but at least now your linebacker and other people is filling the holes. They're filling holes and stopping them for a very little game.
And it's a funny thing what momentum will do for you. It gives you a hope. That kick by Skidmore
good
is going
kick.
To be in the end zone, and it is a touchback. So it will be Madison football at the 15-yard line, and you got to believe that Fred McLean probably lit a fire under his offensive line and his whole team as their 16-point lead is dwindled to 4.
I'm amazed at how he got that. You know, he might have a little wind behind him, but for a freshman to kick the ball, you know, that's a good stout lead for a freshman, isn't it?
Kicking not
it
bad.
In the end zone.
First and 15.
There we go.
First and 10 from the 15. And it's Shanky up the middle. Big hole. Look out. Slavin tries to run him down and bring Shanky down at the 34-yard line.
Quick
Wyatt
hitter.
Slavin saves the touchdown. 31 yards on the carry.
That's the strength of that 6'1", 192, and is a quick hitter. Very quick hitter.
And you look at him coming down the sideline. Slavin had the speed to catch him, but he also had to have the strength to bring him down.
He's had just running the ball like that. He had 176 carries coming into the state's game for 1,892 yards, 45 touchdowns. He averages over 10 yards per rush.
Right now, Hunter Brown, leading tackler for this team on the sidelines for South Gray. And they're going to throw at Kyle a little dump pass intended for Bubba Smith is incomplete. Gallegos on the coverage for the Rebels, second down and 10.
Bubba has had 5 receptions for 77 yards coming into the state game, you know, in their 12 previous games. The 6'6", 216-pound senior, number 66, the left tight end for those Madison Bulldogs.
And a good job by Gallegos to stay in coverage.
Yep,
right idea for Madison to try and see if they can surprise him with a little dump pass. Second and 10. Shanky right up the gut, some running room. Colton Dirks holds on for dear life after a pickup of 6 on the play. Sarah leading the way right up the gut.
Yeah,
and
great.
Matthew Glazer with also a good block out there.
Yeah, the line's done a good job for him. Matthew Glazer, of course, 6 foot, 181-pound junior, number 30, playing left guard. And, of course, Nick Young's the right guard. 6'2", somewhere between 270 and 280 pounds. He's a load, isn't he? Number 54. Wow.
Third down and 4. Big play right here. South Gray blitzes everybody. To the outside comes Kyle. He's hit very close to the first down as Dirks brings him down inside the 25.
I think it's going to be a move of the sticks, looks like.
Down at the 23. It is a first down, a pickup of 4 on the play. .5:11 to go third quarter.
Now look for a quick hitter up the middle again. Trying to surprise him. He's kind of tried to go off tackle and wide a couple plays. Now you use a counter or some quick hitter up the gut again.
South Gray would love to force him into another throwing situation. First and 10, 23-yard line. Coming to the near side is Bybee with the football. He's got some running room. He's cut down. Slavin in on the tackle. Nick Young leading the way, the big one, from his right guard position. 6'4" yards on the carry.
One of the few times that that Tanner Bybee's carried the ball today, that 6'2", 178-pound senior. He's had 25 carries for 265 yards, 10 touchdowns this year. So when he does run the ball, he averages over 10 yards per rush per carry.
Second down and a long 3. It is Shanky. He's got a first down carry to the 11. Picks up 5 on the play. Mosher in on the tackle for the Rebels.
And you had, of course, Dallas Thompson in motion again, you know. And then they just cut right back behind us, you know. Tries to kick somebody out, and then Shanky runs underneath of it.
More often than not, that motion's going to lead you towards the play.
Absolutely. We'll look for a little trigger maybe later on that way just to fool them a little, huh?
Got to keep them honest. First and 10 from the 11. And it's Bybee again. He's got us some space. Stretches the ball down to the 3. Pickup of, we'll say a pickup to the 4-yard line, a pickup of 7 on the play, 2nd and 3. Entire offensive line on the right side really pushing things for the Bulldogs.
Yep, they send old Tanner Bybee in motion. This time they gave it to him. Previously, they did a little trickery and gave it to Shanky going the opposite direction, a little misdirection.
And here comes Shanky. He is in some trouble. Breaks free. He's out of bounds, though. Friesen in on the hit down towards the goal line, and it is going to be 3rd down. Third down and short. The ball just outside the 1-yard line.
Need the length of a football to get the first down without getting a touchdown, or they'll probably just run it right on in there. See how the Rebels defense stand.
It's Shanky, near side. He is in for the touchdown. Cole Shanky with his 2nd touchdown run of the ball game. 2:54 to go, 3rd quarter. Madison up by 10. It is 22-12 Bulldogs.
That's just good running by Cole Shanky, like he's done all afternoon.
Now a 2-point conversion that could be very big.
Absolutely.
Calling Kyle into the huddle with his teammates.
Fred McClain, he came over the sideline to get the play from coach, and so now we'll see what it is. 1 back set.
Thompson in motion. And Shanky, there's a pass. Wide open, Bybee. 2-point conversion is good. And it's a 12-point lead for the Bulldogs with 2:54 to go in the third. Calling Kyle to Tanner Bybee for the 2-point conversion.
Yep, great fake in there to Cole Shanky. Of course, there it is.
There's the touchdown run right there. Shanky corkscrewed himself into the end zone. And it is a 12-point lead, but South Gray has shown that they can move the ball through the air. And I really did not think I would say this today, but I expect the Rebels to go back to the air.
I think so. That's how they got in this game, obviously. So I think you're right. But wasn't that a great 2-point extra point play? I mean, you fake the ball to Shanky, who's been the number one ground gainer all afternoon, all day. And you fake it there, and you send Bybee in motion ahead of him. He just goes to the line untouched. And then the good old left-handed quarterback, Colin Kyle, just lofts it right in the end zone, the corner of it. Nobody else around. 2-point good.
You had to get that left-handed thing in there, didn't you?
Yeah, I can identify with that. You got to understand, 50 years ago, I was had that same position on the team. Let's put it that way.
So it will be
dated, yeah.
Madison kicking off. And South Gray is going to want to try and answer here.
Thompson
boots that one in. It is going to be picked up on the bounce by Colt. Coulter Croft, he's on the run. Look out to midfield, brought down at the 39-yard line.
That was a determined run if I ever saw one.
They're going to mark it at the 38. Boy, he squirted it out of there. Looked like he was going to be brought down and found a way to get through.
What a great job by Coulter Croft. He's a pretty good little spark plug for them Rebels, huh?
Not too shabby. 1st and 10 from the Madison 38-yard line. Hunter Brown is in at center, so had a rest, maybe a take job. Slavin pitches it back. A little cut back for Croft, and he is not going to even get back to the line of scrimmage. Kyle and Fivey on the tackle.
You got Hunter Brown out there. They missed a couple blocks out there to kind of spring him loose. Or Madison did a great job of keeping him from blocking him out of the play, and so that's the reason why he lost a little bit. Got to control that line of scrimmage, and you got to sustain your blocks. This time they got him messed up. So look for a passing formation by, of course, Wyatt Slavin, and he throws a good ball.
2nd down and 11. Slavin's going to throw it. He's under some pressure. He is in some trouble. He's hit. He is dropped. Willie Derryberry from his linebacker position with the sack all the way back inside the 40 down at the 38-yard line. It will bring up third down and 14, a loss of three.
They had the old blitz game coming in with old Willie Derryberry, number 44, that 6 foot, 170-pound junior. And they said we're going to hear Willie Derryberry's name quite a bit today, and we have. Pretty good linebacker, Emerald Bubba Smith.
Now South Gray facing a third down and long. A minute 27 and counting here in the third quarter. Slavin under center.
Getting ready to stun
He's
again.
He's going to throw it again under pressure.
Derryberry.
He's going to run it. He is in some trouble. Still on his feet. Finds a way. He is going to be pushed out of bounds.
Close.
He's going to have a first down. Depending on the mark, it looks like he's going to have a first down.
He was zigging and zagging all the way down there, making them miss him.
Needed 14. Did he get it? The replay. Somehow he tightrope down the sideline, and it's the first down. Coulter Croft picked up a blitz on that play, Larry Jansen.
By
sprung Slavin to the outside.
Yeah, because Willie Derryberry was coming in again, like drawing that blitz. He couldn't. He was so anxious. About jumped off sides.
There's the delayed handoff to Croft. He has a little bit of running room and strong arm down on the play by
Bubba
Smith. What a name for a football player.
Well, it's quite, you know, in the book of the program, of course, it's got his name as Wyatt Smith tied in. And
yeah,
I bet he'd go Bubba.
But
we go Bubba.
Bubba.
I like Bubba. Bubba's better, isn't it?
That's more like it.
And you got play coming in here by Ronald Martins. Lots of time they substitute him in and out. Either Storm Moser comes in on defense, Ronald Martins comes in on offense, and right in.
Joe Carter in at the left tackle or left guard position. Second and five, they're going to throw. Slavin looks, dumps it over. It's a high pass. It is incomplete.
Almost intercepted.
Looked like it might have been intended for Dirks. It went over him, and Williams was back there, got his hand on it, but couldn't bring it down. Third down and five.
I think it hit him on the pads before he get his hands loose, so as far as Tyler Williams, the 6 foot, 158-pound senior playing safety for the Bulldogs.
Replay right here as you see Williams just about pulled that thing in. Got some famous names out on the football field right now, Larry.
Yeah, Bubba Smith.
Joe Carter.
Yeah, Joe Carter.
Real World Series hero for the Blue Jays.
But wrong game, isn't it?
Bubba Smith, football player and a police academy fame. And Slavin in trouble, goes up the middle, he's stopped. He's
Shanky.
Going to be brought down by Shanky. No gain on the play. Third, fourth down, and a long five. And that is likely going to be the final play of the third quarter.
That's been a fun one, though.
Well, South Haven got themselves back into the football, or South Gray got themselves back into the football game. The Rebels score 12 in the third. They trail by 12 as we go to the fourth quarter here on Smoky Hills Public Television.
Presentation of the 8-man Division I football championship is brought to you in part by...
From Rural Telephone and Nextech, providing the region with telephone, internet, cable television, and wireless phone solutions, Rural Telephone and Nextech proudly support public broadcasting and all ventures dedicated to improving Kansas communities.
American Lodge and Suites in Heston, offering a welcoming lobby with fireplace, 42 rooms including jacuzzi suites, indoor pool and spa, continental breakfast, and meeting room. American Lodge and Suites in Heston, welcome to the end of the day.
Max Jantz Excavating, LLC of Montezuma, a contractor specializing in turnkey construction. From feedyard operations to ethanol plants, dairies, and wind farms, your project will be completed on time and within budget. Family-owned Madison Telephone, LLC, serving the Madison and Lamont areas for 65 years, supporting the Madison Bulldogs in athletics and academic endeavors. Montezuma State Bank, a proud sponsor of today's coverage of South Gray, and congratulations to the team on a great season. ADM of Montezuma and Copeland, thanking you for all your business and proud of the jobs our kids have done. Trevis Eatery of Madison, offering daily specials, fresh baked breads and desserts, deli sandwiches, and fried chicken dinners, and Sunday lunch. Dina Smith, Accounting of Madison, for all your tax and accounting needs. Congratulating the Madison Bulldogs for making it to state. Borth Agency Incorporated of Montezuma, for your insurance needs. Not just your agent, your advocate. Information available at 800-501-7637. Shanky Well Service Incorporated, Madison. Citizen State Bank, Madison and Hamilton. Tricky Insurance of Copeland. Circle K Transport Incorporated of Copeland.
And welcome back to Fisher Field in Newton. A big play coming up as we start the fourth quarter for the South Gray Rebels. They trail 24-12. Here on Smoky Hills Public Television, they face a fourth down and six, Larry Jantz. And it is going to be a big play here, and now they're going into the wind. It's going to make that passing game a whole lot tougher.
Oh, they just throw a curveball. Yeah, a little sinker, a curve, sinker. You were talking about Joe Carter, wasn't you, a while ago?
I was talking about Joe Carter. Number 90 for the South Gray Rebels. He's lined up on the left side as Hunter Brown, the center, still having ankle problems. He's limping out to cover that ball, and you know he is hurting right now. They're going to have two wide receivers to the near side. A little courage out there for that young man.
Absolutely.
Fourth and six. Madison fans on their feet. Slavin to throw it. Has a man open. It's Colton Dirks had it. Would have had a first down, but dropped it. Oh, big play. And a beautiful pass from Slavin, and Dirks just dropped it. Now he's got to get his head screwed on straight.
The ball came in, hit him on the shoulder pads. He was starting to look to run before he actually caught the pass with his hands. So it bounced off his shoulder pads in front of his chest. And nobody feels any worse about it than what he does right now, but he's had a heck of a ball game.
Now the Rebels need to see if they can force a turnover. Shanky upended, not much on that play. Dirks on the tackle, a pickup of about a yard and a half, 2 yards on the play, second and eight. Unofficially, that puts Shanky at the 200-yard mark. 30 carries, 200 yards. Somebody get that man an ice pack. He might need it after this one's over.
Yeah, no kidding. But so far, you know, all during the year, the Madison Bulldogs have averaged over 54 points a game. So right now, it's pretty good defense by the South Gray to hold it down to where they're at right now.
Second and eight. They're going to throw it. Kyle out in the flats. It is caught. A first down at the South Gray 38-yard line. Bubba Smith reels it in.
216-pound senior tight end, left tight end. A little down and out pass pattern, and left-handed Colton Kyle.
Nailed. There's the throw. As you see Kyle throw it up there. Smith goes high to bring it in. Good hit. Put on the play by Slavin, but just not enough. First down from the 38.
Pass pattern like that, either going the receiver or going out of bounds. He did a safe job.
Shanky goes to the outside. Gallegos meets him and brings him down. Coulter Croft forced him to the inside.
Yeah,
and second down.
Another great kick out block to kind of free up Cole Shanky for the deal. And you got Tyler Williams coming in here giving old 23 Dallas Thompson up Blake a break here right now.
They're going to say a gain of three on the play. Second and seven. Kyle again. Bybee wide open. It is caught. Touchdown, Bulldogs. Tanner Bybee. 35 yards from Colin Kyle, and Madison on top, 30-12. A huge play for the Bulldogs.
Yeah, caught him sleeping. They had two guys open that time. He got Tyler or Tanner, Bybee, down the middle that time.
And an 18-point lead, the largest of the ball game for Madison.
And we're bringing up here for a two-point extra point attempt.
Kyle pitches to Shanky. Little bit of a lead for Cole, and he is not going to make it as he got hammered at the goal line. So a 10-24 to go at the ball game. Now South Gray trailing by 18.
Henry Friesen is one of the sophomore. 5'9", 230-pound sophomore come in there and kind of level Shanky before he could cross the goal line. So great job by the sophomore linebacker for South Gray Rebels, Henry Friesen.
Now you got to see what South Gray's going to do offensively. They've been able to move the ball here in the second half, but now trailing by three possessions, which makes it awfully tough against a team that loves to run the football because they can control that line of scrimmage.
Yeah, that's a great job here. Now we'll find out. They've been kicking the ball for in the end zone, remember, hitting the crossbars. Let's see if they can do it again. Have a touchback for the Rebels.
I'll bet they might have a chance to do it again.
If they do, then the Rebels will start with a 65 yards to go for a touchdown if it happens.
Madison 12-0 on the season. They rolled through their schedule starting all the way back on September 2nd. Here we are 2.5 months later playing for a state championship, looking to bring the second state championship to the Madison football program. Thompson descended into the stratosphere, and away it goes. And short and wide left if you're looking for it to go through the uprights that time.
That's the first one he's had that way. It's been short and wide left. But the wind ain't quite as strong today as what it was earlier. But still goes down as a touchback, and so the South Gray Rebels will have 65 yards from their own 15-yard line. 65 yards to go to try to narrow the gap. Take some of those 18 points away you're talking about, or 20.
First down and 10 from the 15-yard line, 30-12. South Gray trails by 18. It is cropped, shakes the tackle. Bates in on the hit. Bubba Smith in there as well. Willie Derryberry. Savin Bates with a hit for the Bulldogs. A pickup of 3, 2nd and 7.
Yeah, they almost had a fumble in the backfield that time, looked like. Between Slavin and Croft.
4.4 yards a carry for Croft. Slavin looking for an opening. And Smith on the tackle. And Slavin picks up 4. Third down and a short 3.
Well, the play's coming back in there from, of course, number 3, Ronald Martins. Yep, Ronald Martins. He brings the play in from Coach Blattner. So we'll see what they got up their sleeve.
Third and three, they need it here. Cross is going to be stacked up. He's going to pick up a yard on the play. Gutierrez leading the charge, and he has been dominating the middle of that line today. Pickup of 2, 4th down and 1.
He's had experience in that. Last year, say, remember, he played both sides of the ball. He was starting center a year ago and also nose guard. This year just concentrates on one side of the ball.
4th and 1. Slavin's got a first down, picks up 3. Williams, Shanky, Derryberry, all with the part of that tackle. First down for South Gray.
Yep, Willie Derryberry and Tyler Williams in on the tackle. Tyler Williams, a senior, 160-pounder. Derryberry, a junior, 170-pounder.
1st and 10. There's a pitch out. Croft gets a lead block, a nice one from Carter, and he'll pick up 7 on the play. Now, Bubba Carter Smith. Tanner Bybee in on the hit.
That's a good first. Anytime you get 7 yards on the first play of a 1st and 10, It gives you more options down that second and short or second and three.
8 minutes to go here in the ball game. South Gray trailing. Gallegos gets a carry. He picks up about a half a yard, maybe. Gutierrez submarines under and says, that's enough. Dallas Thompson also there.
Yeah, they cut a nice little roadblock in there. Little man wins, as I always say, in defense, and they were in there submarining and clogged up the hole, and there wasn't any place for him to go.
Now South Gray needs to score, and need to score in a hurry. 7.5 to go in the ball game. It is a little bit of a hill to climb against the defending state champions. Slavin to throw. Gets Happy Feet, steps up in the pocket. He is going to be close. He is going to have the first down. He picked up three.
If you go by Rodney Palin's left foot over there, he's made it.
He has got the first down. And they will move the chains. First down and 10, South Gray. Pick up a three for Wyatt Slavin.
Your zebra crew today has got George Ebert as the referee, Chris Robaugh umpire, linesman Rodney Palin, line judge Ron Hagg, and then back judge is Wyatt Cole.
Croft, left side, lowers his shoulder, shoved out of bounds. Bybee out there. Smith helped usher him out over there on the far side as they cross into Madison territory. 4 yards on the carry, second and six.
That was a good run on first down.
Clock winds under 7 minutes to go. There goes Slavin, gets a lead block. Watts out there helping him along towards the first down marker.
Colin Coggin up a little slow, wasn't he?
He's going to pick up a couple on the play. It'll bring up, pick up a three. Third down and three. And we're going to have a timeout on the field. We'll keep it here with 6:55 to go in the ball game, Larry. Timeout by South Gray. And the Rebels, trailing by 18 points, are going to have to find a way to get this ball in the end zone and get it in a hurry because time is not on their side. And we talk about the Madison offense, about how they can run the ball and how they can suck the time off the clock. Right now, really, the defense is doing that job because they are not allowing any big plays. They're keeping South Gray in check. And although the Rebels are moving the ball down the field, they're using a lot of time in the process.
Yeah, that's the best of both worlds for the Madison Bulldogs right now. South Gray, but like you said, they're not hustling to get the ball in the end zone. And I think they need to open up with a little passes. They don't need to have the long passes, just 5 and out, 7 and out, 8 and out. Do like Colin Kyle was doing earlier, the pass routes need to be short and sweet out to the sideline so only your receiver gets the ball or nobody does. Don't throw it over the middle, I don't think.
Third down and three for the Rebels. The Madison fans getting into this thing. It is a zone read, and Derryberry brings Wyatt Slavin down after a pickup of a yard on the play. We'll call it a pickup of two. It's going to bring up fourth down and a long one for the Rebels.
Yeah, Wyatt Slavin was doing a little zigging and zagging out there. Didn't know he was going to go on the left side, and looked like he's closed it down, so he goes on the right side, so he goes back to the left, and then Willie Derryberry caught up with him, number 44 for the Bulldogs.
Fourth down and one for the Rebels. And Croft leads. He's not going to get there. Dallas Thompson on the stop. He needed a little more than a yard. He got about a half a yard. And the Madison defense stands up tall and stops the Rebels.
All I got to say is that we had the old thoroughbred trader out here today. That Dallas Thompson is going to be on my horse trader, my thoroughbred trader, huh?
Remember how
we did that?
He's had himself a ball game.
Yeah.
First down and 10. 6:16 to go, and now the Madison offense can start to put this thing away.
A little ball control.
I wouldn't be surprised to see him play action here and try and catch South Gray off guard, but when you have Shanky in the backfield, why do that when he can pound away for 6 yards on first down?
Or more.
And he trucked one of the South Gray players who's down on the field right now. Have an injury on the field for the Rebels.
Official timeout.
An injury timeout. You hate to see that. Shanky picked up 6 on the play. Actually, 7. Will bring up 2nd down and 3. Cole Shanky, unofficially, 32 carries, 210 yards, 2 touchdowns. Pretty darn good effort by that young man.
Did you expect anything less?
Not really. I expected him to have a good game, and it's exactly what he's doing. And good show of support from the Madison sideline as they get down on a knee as tend to the injured South Gray Rebel. Look like it might be
lower leg issue.
Hunter Brown. Not for sure, but looks like him down there. And he's been dealing with that lower leg all ball game. And that could be the...
Got the athletic director Mark Appleby coming out there to help the coaches.
It looks like he's going to be up, and actually that's Gallegos. So Gallegos slow to get up after the 7-yard carry from Cole Shanky. .559 to go. That running game, which was so potent for South Gray all season long, unofficially 115 yards today.
I think that was incredible respect by the Madison Bulldogs kneeling down and taking off their helmets while that player was hurting on the field.
And we're going to have a
timeout by Madison.
And one thing you'll notice with the Bulldogs is they are deliberately taking a lot of time off this clock. They're not hurrying in and out of the huddle. You'll watch Colin Kyle. He'll walk over towards the sideline, get the play, get back in the huddle, get up to the line, and they'll be snapping it with not a ton of time left on the play clock, which allows more of that clock. And when you have an 18-point lead, you can do that.
Yes, you can. Can't blame him for that.
So with 5:53 on the fourth quarter clock, it is an 18-point lead for the defending 8-man Division I state champions, and they're looking to repeat right here in the sideline. Is excited. The fans here, the pep man going pretty good. And a 2nd down and 3. Henry Friesen, the 5'9", 230-pound sophomore, back out in the linebacking core. Second and 3, a missed handoff there. Shanky is pushed backwards. And the aforementioned Friesen in on the tackle. A loss of 3 on the play. It will bring up 3rd and 6.
He's a 230-pound sophomore, 5'9". Henry Friesen. He did a great job there because he just blitzed right in there. Now, Hunter Brown goes off. He's limping. He's got some lower leg issues.
And Gallegos back into the ball game. 3rd and 6 for the Madison Bulldogs. Kyle to throw it up the field. Incomplete. Intended for Bybee. Slavin on the coverage for South Gray, and it's 4th down and most likely a punting situation for Madison. And last time Madison punted to the football, South Gray got awfully close to blocking that, and a blocked punt return for a touchdown here could make a big difference.
And this is only about their 2nd punt all day, isn't it?
Second punt. And the kick is away.
Oh, not a good one.
High one, and it is short, and it is way out of bounds. And it is not going to be a good
Rodney field position. Walking back
all the way up at the 29-yard line.
Wow.
So first and 10 from the 29-yard line.
On the net of about
14 yards. Net of 14 yards on that kick.
Wow. Well, that's kind of what South Bray needed.
Well, their chances are slim right now.
Absolutely, we know that, but they have to put the ball in the air, I think. The last series proved the point. You better use some misdirection, some play-action passes, and Slavin needs to have some good spirals and down-and-out patterns.
And another timeout's going to be called by South Gray. Rebels use a timeout with 5:04 to go here in the fourth quarter. They trail 30-12, and Larry, only one timeout remaining now for the Rebels, so they are not going to be able to use. I mean, they're going to need to use that last timeout in order to stop the clock if they're able to actually put points on the board.
And they need to score on this possession. They need to score quick. And then they're going to see your onside kick and then try to get it back. And then, like you said, only have that one timeout left. So we'll see what the brain trust over there, Grant Salmons and Coach Jeff Blattner, have figured out what they want to play here on first and 10 from their own 29-yard line.
See if they give them a little razzle-dazzle on this play.
Need to have some play-action passes or something. Pretty quick. Going to Haston or the old popcorn formation.
Back to throw, Slavin. Looking down the field. That ball hangs up, has a man. Croft cannot bring it down. He was open and beat the defender, Bybee, on the other side, but that pass just sailed towards the out-of-bounds and didn't really lead Croft down the field too well.
It was only about a foot probably out of his reach of his hands. Probably just missed it there. He's almost had it.
They have thrown the ball down the left side of the field quite a bit. Now we'll see if they maybe try something on the backside, try and sneak somebody out and get them in the flats open.
Jake Peters, a freshman, is in the game now for South Gray out here. Split clear out to the right.
Second and 10. Slavin under pressure. Dump pass knocked away by Derryberry, intended for
Croft, I think.
Croft. Gutierrez got his hands on it. Third down and 10.
Going to knock down pass by number 98.
Third down and 10. Two incomplete passes by South Gray.
That's pretty good honor, though, that Jake Peters, a freshman, he got to come in there and play a little split in. They got Ronald Martin split.
That ball's on the ground, and Slavin just has to fall on it. He loses three back to the 25. It's fourth down and 13. No, they've been able to convert on some third and longs and a fourth and long. We'll see if they can do it here.
Yeah.
Four and a half to go.
They better need 14 good yards here on this play.
They're showing punt. Madison doesn't believe it.
Now they do.
And they kick it away, and it is going to bounce out of bounds at about the 28-yard line, 29. Yeah, now they keep marking it up. Continues to go at the 31, 32-yard line, I believe. So first and 10 for Madison. 4:10 to go in this one. And I would be awfully surprised if the Bulldogs put this thing in the air.
Well, yeah, they want to kill the clock and get out of here. It's going to be shanky. Left or right, probably, huh?
Just little right.
Yep.
Lowers his shoulder up to the 35.
Keeps the clock moving.
Hayden's here, leading the way. Second and 7.
Okay. All right. Yeah, Sarah, and also going right over that right guard, that Nick Young, that 6'2", 272-pound junior.
And Colin Kyle very aware of the clock as he goes into the huddle. He looks up at the clock, sees where his team is at. And will settle in underneath center with 7 seconds on the play clock. Here's a pitch to Shanky. Comes near side, has a cutback. Shanky! First down! 29-yard line. Glazier pays the way for him as he picks up big yardage to the South Gray 29-yard line.
That's a great cutback, too, against the grain. Finally stopped in there by Colton Croft.
There's the cutback, and Shanky on a 16-yard carry.
He's got quite a few yards today, don't it, Jeremy, for the day so far.
Unofficially, 35 carries, 226 yards.
He's trying to go after what he did a year ago.
Needs 29 more to get there. He got a touchdown here. That would tie him with what he had last year. Up the middle, and they are just starting to dominate again. Glazier with a pancake block. Pickup of 6, second and 4. Friesen and Carter in on the tackle. 2.5 to go in the ball game. Madison Bulldogs are going to win their second consecutive state championship. South Gray Rebels, I know that not the result they wanted, but they put up a pretty darn good fight today. And this time it's going to be Kyle, close to the first down, brought down on the play by Mosher. And we'll see if they move him forward or not. It is a first down, so a pickup of 4 on the play for Colin Kyle. First down and 10 from the 19-yard line.
The red zone.
Shanky cuts it back across the grain, and a good job by Dirks. He's there along with Carter and Gallegos. A couple on the play, second and 8. A minute and a half to go. Gutierrez coming down the line. He might get himself a chance to go in the ball game. Hand in hand with fellow senior Tyler Williams. Second and 8. Here comes Bybee on the round. Glazier with a good block and a tackle by Slavin. Also Carter in on the hit.
Brings up fourth down little.
Young, Sarah, Glazier just doing a heck of a job paving the way. Third down and 3.
And under a minute.
They'll have to run maybe 2 more plays. Possibly 1. Nope. And Colin Kyle is going to back up, put his knee down. And the official is going to look back, and they are going to set the ball just in time that the play clock will run out, and that is going to do it. The Madison Bulldogs are going to be your Kansas State High School Activities Association 8-man Division I state champions for the second year in a row, and the confetti flies, and the Bulldogs are your state champions from Fisher Field and Newton. I'll tell you what, with the wind blowing like it does, like it is,
it's kind of a pretty sight.
That confetti they're kicking up out here is flying around pretty darn good.
It's like a bunch of multicolored butterflies.
I don't know what the staff here in Newton thinks about having to clean up confetti, but hey, it's a good time.
Well, the wind will blow it away. It'll be in Nebraska or Oklahoma tomorrow.
Well, Larry, Madison's second straight state title, and well-deserving because it's one heck of a football team.
Yeah, they are. They're a smooth machine. They're a sound machine. They don't make very many mistakes. They don't beat themselves. You got to give credit to the second half, the adjustments that the coaching staff made for South Gray to come back in there, and they, for once, run there 16-12, so they closed the gap. And they tried to make a very interesting game out, but then all of a sudden they think they run out of gas a little bit down the stretch, a little bit, because they had spent so much time on defense. And they're not comfortable using the passing game as much as they're kind of forced to try to get into it. But the blitzing package, the defensive strategy, defense, like Coach Fred McLean said earlier, defense wins championships. And defense today certainly won the championship for the Madison Bulldogs, that's for sure.
And I'll tell you what, you look in the middle of that line for Madison, and in the linebacking core, really the core of that defense on the inside with Gutierrez at the nose guard, Jerry Berry, and Bubba Smith.
Yep.
It seemed like we were calling their names on nearly every play.
Yeah, and you throw in, don't forget Dallas Thompson. I mean, that Dallas Thompson was everywhere, either offense and defense, but he's threw a lot of blocks out there, and he was making a lot of tackles, you know. On offense, remember, he was the one that's like going in motion a lot of times, and then he'd knock that Colton Croft kid outside, and then Shanky would cut up underneath of it. So, but you're right, on defense, Damon Gutierrez, number 98, the 5'10", 212 senior. And there they are.
There is your 8-man Division I state champions, and that trophy right there, that's going
to
look pretty sweet on the trophy case, back-to-back,
right next to
each other.
Back-to-back Division I, 8-man state championships in the state of Kansas. How sweet it is for the Madison Bulldogs.
And that is, it's not easy to do.
No.
It's not easy to repeat, because once you win one, there is a target on you every week out. 13 weeks in a row, the Bulldogs had that target. And 13 weeks in a row, they dodged the opponent.
And if you take the last three games here in the playoff for Madison to get to this point, they've averaged over 50 points a game. Yeah, one of them they had 46-8, then 50-18, and then 52-6. But today, you know, South Gray, give them credit. They held them down underneath their scoring average, what they've been doing. They've been averaging 54 points a game. So it was pretty good.
I tell you, it's a fun game. Fred McLean and his crew should be very proud of what they accomplished. Jeff Blattner and his team should be extremely proud of what they accomplished as well. Even though they didn't win this ball game, this group has won throughout the year.
Oh, yeah. Well, but they had somebody that give up. Both of them, one of them is 11-0, South Grade 11-0, and the Madison Bulldogs 12-0, now 13-0. So, 11-1 is nothing to be to hold your head down about. They're all winners on the field. They're all winners. They played like winners. They stay competitive all the time. And so it's a great accomplishment to both teams. And like always, great sportsmanship, too.
So, the Madison Bulldogs, you see this 2011 state championship team there, right there, as they celebrate, as they win it by a score of 30-12 over the South Gray Rebels. Special thanks to the entire staff at Smoky Hill Public Television out here making this broadcast possible. Without everybody, it just wouldn't happen. Also, special thanks to color analyst Larry Jantz. This is Jeremy McGuire saying so long from Fisher Field in Newton. The Madison Bulldogs are your 2011 state champions.